get up.
Oh, hey. There's another one. Ancient terminal. Everything here is so ancient. Alright, Hums and Throbs. Liquor store life. This always works. Dang it. Hello? Sure, interdict bet. Yes. This isn't working. Oh. Huh. Life-giving seed world. Oceanic. Real. Did I win? I think I won. It's like a little puzzle or something.
I'm here.
Whoa.
What?
Okay. One down. Yeah, you thought you could fool me. Alright. We're not going through that room again. So this one's a little easier. No, it's exactly the same. Great. Wait. Don't I have an ion grenade? Let's throw a couple of those before we go at it. Boom. That did some damage. All right, let's go. What? Stop freezing me, I don't want you to.
Just die already! Yes?
That's what you disable, you just do your thing. You keep freezing me, but that's okay.
You'll pay!
Alright, well that doesn't take much force though.
That
do use bunch of those.
I heard I yes.
Oh, that went a lot quicker. Got any remains for me? That circle usually means there's remains, but the game doesn't want me to look at the remains. Oh, got it. No, I didn't. I'm accessing the terminal. Alright, puzzle time. First, kick it. Nope, didn't work. That's a dead bed. Death more. Okay. Death giving. I assume it's the other ones that weren't there. Death seal. I win. Still can't get the remains, but I guess we'll have to live with that. Alright, did I win? Am I worthy? Oh, score! Alright, I'm in a cutscene right now, I can't even walk. Okay, now I can walk. Oh snap. This is the Stargate thing I was talking about. I know it doesn't actually look like a Stargate, but that was the closest thing I could compare it to.
This must be what Revan and Malik found when they entered the
temple.
Yeah,
no dip. That's literally what we saw in our dream.
The dark side began.
I don't get it.
This is a map. Some sort of intergalactic navigational chart. Revan and Malik must have used this to lead them to the Starforge. We could use this map to follow their path and find the Starforge ourselves, but we must be wary. They may have laid traps or concealed what they found.
Yeah, I don't really get Starforge. I actually meant to type the second one, but I suppose that doesn't matter.
It must be a tool of some type, or maybe a weapon. Perhaps the Council can tell us more. But I think this map might be the key to finding the Starforge, whatever it is. See this world here? This looks like Korriban, a Sith world. And if that's Korriban, then this is
Kashyyyk. I have no idea what she's pointing
to. And Tatooine, and here's Manan. But there are pieces missing. Incomplete hyperspace coordinates, corrupted data. And there doesn't seem to be anything indicating where the Starforge itself might be.
Well, that's very helpful.
I was thinking that too. This map can't take us to the Starforge, but I know that Revan and Malak visited Korriban at least once. Perhaps they discovered something more there. They may have found something on each of the other worlds that completed this map. Maybe if we find all the pieces, they'll lead us to the Starforge, in some way to destroy it. We must inform the Council of what we've discovered. They must decide our next course of action, though I suspect our task has only just begun.
Great. Let's go. Do I need to analyze it with science? I don't think so. Let's go. We win. Actually, hey, either of you ladies want to talk? I have the feeling she's going to say the same thing as usual.
Hey there.
Yeah. Mastos, this is a good time.
How can I help?
What's bothering you?
No, not bothering me. Not exactly. I've been thinking about what the Jedi Council said about...
By the way, the Jedi Council said we were like force bonded or something.
There is a bond between us. I do not dispute that. I can feel it, as I'm sure you can. The nature of that bond and its effect on our mission remain in question.
If you know what I mean. I don't get it, actually.
Our fates are strongly connected. So connected that a literal bond has been forged between us. I saw your service records when you were transferred aboard the Ender Spire, but nothing beyond that. I know very little about you. I'd like to ask you some questions, given our relationship.
Well, I'm kind of a big deal, but yeah. There's got to be a more subtle way to do this kind of thing.
Don't worry, these are simple questions. Nothing too intrusive. First, what kind of background do you have?
Well, I'm apparently a freaking Jedi. I haven't even answered one question that I can say this. Yeah, I'll be honest.
Good. On which planet were you born?
Sure, the one planet that no one's ever heard of.
Excellent. Your current age.
Excellent. What is this? Some kind of right or wrong answer? Alright, I have a feeling I should be starting to get sarcastic.
I see you intend to be childish about this.
I intend to be humorous about this. Right, I'm sorry, you can't tell the difference between the two.
I suppose I'll just have to speak to you again later. Hopefully you'll behave a little less like a little boy and a little more like a... like a man.
I have a feeling there are only three questions, so given that I answered two of them completely honestly, I don't think you really have a right to be calling me out on that. Just because I'm trying to lighten the freaking mood. I get that you're British, but that doesn't give you the right to just make fun of my humor. Always Cat Hound.
You'll never get me.
Besides, that joke wasn't that childish. I'm not gonna let go of this. That wasn't that childish. Like, it was childish, I would have said, word for word, 3012, hee hee hee, can't you tell, because I'm old, and it's funny because I'm not actually old. But the fact that I said, you know, how do you live in here? But you just, it's much more than that. Come on, Dr. Brook. Also, this Adam guy is just a freaking door-to-door salesman, except he doesn't come up to you, so he's not really burger salesman. Okay, yes, I killed the Mandalorians. You're welcome.
Now those Mandalorians know what it's like to be hunted.
Sure.
But now that you've killed some of
them... I already killed them.
Thank you, young master. My daughter can now, I think, rest in peace. Here is the reward I promised you.
Eye for an eye, sure.
Again, I thank you. I will be sure to tell the council of your great deed.
I can't always refuse money. I mean, I have to make money somehow. Alright guys, I fixed it.
Ah, you have returned, young Padawan. Have you discovered what it was that Revan and Malak sought in those ruins?
Kind of.
We should consult the Jedi Archives to see if there's any mention of the Star Forge and what it might do. We must learn why Revan and Malak sought it out.
Return to your ship with Bastila, and we will summon you when we are done.
Okay.
Padawan, you have done well in discovering the star map hidden within the ancient ruins. But there is more you must do in the battle against Malak and the Sith.
Oh, good.
We Jedi, no victory over the Sith will not come through martial might. The Council has a mission for you, Padawan.
I've consulted our vast archives in an effort to discover the nature of this Star Forge, but all my efforts have been in vain.
Still, the Council are in agreement. The Star Forge must be found.
Council is in agreement.
Revan and Malak sought it out when they began their tragic fall. The Star Forge is surely a powerful tool of the Dark
Now, if you had set the members of the Council in agreement, that would make sense.
Showed you four planets, but it was incomplete. It did not show the location of the Star Forge itself. We believe there may be similar star maps on other planets. Each star map is likely a small piece of a larger puzzle. Find the star maps on Kashyyyk, Tatooine, Manon, and Korriban, and we believe they will lead you to the Star Forge.
Sounds like a suicide mission. Just my kind of mission.
Ever brash, ever disrespectful.
Well, then let me send
this
one
is
my
what we have pinned our hopes on.
Peace, Rook. We have discussed this. There is no other choice. The Jedi numbers have been ravaged by this war, by defections to Malak's cause, and by Sith assassins. But we realize the importance of this mission. Yet if we send a company of Jedi Knights with you, we would surely draw the full attention of Malak and the Sith, dooming your efforts to failure. Secrecy is our best defense against the Sith. But it would be foolish to send you on this quest without someone to aid you, young Padawan. Bastila will accompany you, for there is a powerful connection between you two. A connection that might be the key to unraveling the mysteries uncovered by Revan. And Juhani has also asked to accompany you.
Oh, it's the Catwoman.
After long deliberation, we have granted her request.
Juhani nearly fell to the dark side. Perhaps her presence will serve as a reminder to you.
So literally the only reason you're letting her do this is just to tell me, hey, don't do this. Oh wow, my character actually calls it a Catwoman. Yeah, I have an entire
Of course, clue. Those who aided you on Taris will also come. They possess skills you may find useful in your quest. Remember that secrecy and discretion are paramount to your success.
Yep.
You will not be able to hide the fact that you are a Jedi, nor should you. But the true nature of your mission must not reach Malak's ears.
I'm sure he won't get suspicious when he finds out I visit the four planets that he just visited.
A sanctuary for you, a safe haven. Here you can find supplies and whatever advice or other aid we may give you.
Yeah, let's get out there.
You can leave whenever you wish. The sooner, the better. The longer you wait, the stronger Malak becomes. But first, a warning, young Padawan.
What?
The lure of the dark side is difficult to resist. I fear this quest to find the Star Forge could lead you down an all too familiar path.
The fate of the galaxy is in your hands, young Padawan. We pray you are up for the challenge. May the Force be with you.
And also with you. Wait, is that what they say, or am I just doing the whole... May the Lord be with you and also with you, let us pray. I don't know. I think they say that. George Lucas drew inspiration from a bunch of different religions when he was coming up with the Force stuff, so... maybe. Alright, well, let me check all my missions again, but, we don't really have any other reason to stay. I mean, I think Juhani is already aboard the ship. And, I lost my henchmen, but that's okay. What? Yep. That's right. Yeah, I get it. Lots of danger.
Chikun ita hodonga, yikinkuno bamulerati.
Muchishak bakat. Kino no damapaule.
Runda di hodonga kun hunkami. One kun
be. There's a chance I could see like three in this one game.
Takum just tak miki grabble mogo. Kachichu ita tong height wom ji jump lumpa. Nita poe tikito. Dolpa.
That's nice.
Ka chikun ita hodonga. Yiking.
So I remember those Tyrantitechs. Yes, we do come across them, and yes, they're scary, but they're not as bad as that guy makes them come out. It's not like the final boss is a Tyrantitech or anything. Darth Malak riding a Tyrantitech. Now that would be a fun, good final boss. Alright, let's just explore the Ebonhawk Heroes mission. Whoa, whoops, no, cancel. No, I don't want to go out. Okay. So there's a nice swoop bike here, there's more swoop racing later on. Hey, Candorous.
Yeah, what do you want?
War stories.
You want another war story, huh? You want to hear about some other world getting wasted, eh? I knew you were the type. Your stagnant republic has never seen some of the strange creatures and races we fought on the Outer Rim in those years. And you never will now.
So awesome.
We were going through the asteroid fields of the Crispin system at the very edge of the galaxy, playing with the pirates and smugglers we found there. The main belt in the Crispin system consists of mainly small rocks covered in frozen methane gas shells, and the pirates were using them for cover.
Pretty intense.
I remember using a thermal generator to cause the outer layer of one of the asteroids to vaporize in a picosecond. It blew out and shredded the three smugglers using it for cover. But that was a mistake. The asteroid I had targeted was smaller than most, maybe a dozen meters on the side. On the outside, it looked the same as any other, just a ball covered in frozen gas. But something must have been inside it, something inactive in the cold. The heat of my blast might have triggered something or woken something up. After I'd hit it, spots of light and heat appeared all over the thin shell, still covering it, evaporating the gases. What lay underneath looked like some sort of rocky growth. A deformed rock, pitted by scores of micrometeorite scars. I think something even older might have been inside that. Maybe, but maybe not. It started rotating faster and faster as we watched it. After a second, it started spraying fire, thermal projectiles that melted our armor like wax. We were caught completely by surprise.
Nice going, Canvas.
Before we could counterattack, it fled at an incredible speed. We couldn't catch it, but we could follow its hyperspace wake. We followed its trail as far as we could, heading away from the galactic core. When it finally led beyond the edge of our galaxy, we abandoned our efforts. Anything that wants to commit suicide in that great void is not worth our trouble trying to catch. That's the only story I have for now. I'll tell you some more stuff later if we get the chance. Is there something else?
No.
You're...
Alright, let's fix my lightsaber. And maybe make another one. Let's get this one. This one's blue. Plus one attack, one damage. Okay. Let's make that one green. Let's go ahead and go with my plan. Just give it both of those crystals. This one with the upgrades. I think so. Yeah! So much more awesome than all of you. Alright, that's the engine room. We have like a storage room. Is there stuff in here? C3, cell bar, and I guess I'll talk to you.
I feel I must apologize for the way I acted towards you before in the Grove. It was wrong of me.
To try and kill me?
I am sorry for attacking you. I am sorry for thinking you would only try to kill me. I hope that by helping you in your task, I may redeem myself in your eyes, and in my own.
Sure.
Thank you.
You're so laid back. I'm the best captain ever.
I know that you can forgive me, even though I tried to take your life. I can only hope that, in our time journeying together, I will succeed.
Hi guys. What's up? Karth, you have something you'd like to say?
Yes, what's on your mind?
Let's just talk.
Oh, you want to argue some more, is that it?
No. Yes.
So I've seen. If I were Malik, I'd be a bit nervous to have you on my tail.
Nice.
I just don't trust easily, and for good reasons, which are my own.
This is definitely about me.
Oh, damn it. I suppose I won't get any rest until I talk, will I? No. You want to know why I don't trust anyone?
Okay.
Fine. Here goes. 5 years ago, the Jedi had just finished the war with
Malik. Oh, now you're turning into Candace.
Revan and Malik were heroes. I was damn proud to have served them in their fleet. It was completely unexpected when they turned on us, invading the Republic while we were still weak. Nobody knew what to think, least of all me. Our heroes had become brutal, conquering Sith, and we were all but helpless before them. I mean, think about it. If you can't even trust the best of the Jedi, who can you trust?
What does that have to do with me?
It's not that. That's not what I mean. There were others, good, solid, trusted men who joined them. Malik and Revan and the Sith deserve to die for what they've done. But the ones who fled the Republic and joined them are even worse. The dark side has nothing to do with why they joined with the Sith. They deserve no mercy.
That's so self-righteous.
I know. And I should apologize to you. I've become so accustomed to expecting the worst in others, and you've done nothing to deserve that. It's just... No, never mind. Let's just continue with what we were doing. I'd rather not talk about it.
Okay. So let's see. We've got all of our people... Still don't know how to fix this. Maybe once I travel, that'll go away. And then our only side quest is Griff on Tatooine. And then our main quest. So, I don't know how I came up with this process, but I have a specific order I like to play the planets in. I've played through KOTOR a couple times, and I always go through the same order. You're allowed to pick any order you want of the four... that was not on the list. Anyway, there's Kashyyyk, Manon, Corban, Tatooine. You're technically allowed to pick them in any order you want, but I don't know how I come up in this order, but I generally go Tatooine, Kashyyyk, Manon, Corban. Definitely save Corban for last because it's the frickin' Sith homeworld. I think the first time I played through, I chose Tatooine just because it was familiar. It's in all the movies. Kashyyyk was the next familiar, it was the one I was next comfortable with. Manon I knew nothing about, but it seemed alright, so we went third, and then Corban was a freaking Sith planet, so I avoided that. So, I think we'll stick with that order, it kinda makes sense. Everyone knows Tatooine, so we'll go to Tatooine next time, but for now, I'm going to collect quits for tonight.